But I am beautiful, no matter what they say.
The purpose of this video is I've gotten so many requests from a lot of you asking me, how exactly is it that you manage to keep yourself so fit? How I keep my skin so flawless? How my hair does that cool, you know, kind of thing on the side? So this is what this is going to be about. So, come on. So this is the first step into Nandoism. This is the equipment, the tools that I use. And this is just for the upper body part. I have a whole routine that takes place for the lower part, which you're not gonna see. Now, you have to be very careful not to mess up. Because if you do, your fans, whoops, don't be dumb now, your fans will start to revolt. Just like when Jennifer Lopez went blonde. This is my shaving technique, passed down to me, not by my father, but my aunt, who used to get up every morning and shave. She had a rare thyroid condition that caused abnormal hair growth on her face. And she taught me which razors to use. She was also very helpful in telling me that pre-shave oil is a must. And you always, always shave after you shower. It opens up the pores. She also used to say it would expose her butt, but Aunt Meta was a little nuts. Part of the routine, it's very important that you use the appropriate moisturizing tools that will get you the results that you need. And people will always ask you what you use. And the people range, they vary. You know, it could be anyone from, you know, your supervisor to the butcher. I have homeless people stop me all the time, saying, you know, if I looked like you, I don't think I would be homeless. And I take that as a compliment. The next step in the routine is getting the hair appropriately straightened that will yield in the appropriate results. Now you might ask yourself, what are those appropriate results? Well, you know, it varies. Sometimes, you know, when I get ready for work, I feel there's no one to impress at work, you know. The girls at work don't even do their own hair. So, you know, anything I do, as long as I smear some mousse on there, it'll be an improvement to what I see them going. Okay? You just don't use whatever. And you have to know your hair type. You have to know what you can do with your hair and what you can't. There's just so many options. Yeah, there's just so many options that you can do with the hair. And I think today I might demonstrate a few looks for you. You know, I know that's a treat, and you've been really waiting for this, so why not? Yeah? All right. Those of you with no hair, I would definitely recommend not going out in public, but if you have to, you know, if you have to, then, you know, definitely you have options like weaves, wigs, just, you know, different options. I really don't know. I've always had hair. I have it on my back. I can show you if you like. But I have hair, so I don't really have to worry about these things. Now, this is the kind of hairstyle I would use to go on job interview. You know? They would see me coming and be like, that's the professional we want to hire. That's him. There's nothing more to it. That's him. Now, if I'm going to try and impress someone on a first date, then I want to show them I'm a little bit more creative, a little bit more spontaneous. Oh, you know? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to bring it together. And voila. There you go. Instant date here. Proper hold. Because the last thing you want is to spend all this time getting it together and it not holding. So you use the appropriate styling techniques to top it off. So once you have the hair, the face, everything kind of done, then the next thing is actually picking out your wardrobe. You want to make sure that it's also appropriate to the situation. You know, if you are going to work, you might want to throw on something long sleeve, weather appropriate. If you're going on a first date, if this is the first time you're meeting someone, then you might want to wear something impressive, something flashy, something that says, this is who I am, accept me. If you're just going to meet someone for sex, then you just might want to get something that pulls off really quick.
Make sure that you put on your coat. That makes you look good. If you're leaving for work, make sure you have your proper work attire, equipment, laptop, briefcase, you know, etc. If you're a spy going to work, make sure you have, you know, your microfilm, your passwords, your secret keys. Can't leave home without your wallet, even if you're broke, as is my case. You have your Metro card to get onto the train, and the piece de resistance. And I think it's one of the reasons why I get stopped, besides my devastatingly beautiful skin, is imperfectly shaped eyebrows that are so natural. Like, it's unbelievable. Seriously, it's a gift. You know? I'm just gonna... There you go. So, I am off to go buy some toilet paper. So, I will see you, but this has been fun. I hope that you've enjoyed a day into the life of achieving Nandoism. 'Cause I'm a boss.